Hi guys, how are you? We're back, okay? We're going to review the specific properties of matter today. We have seen five properties. I know you all may know them, but it's good to review them just in case, okay? So we are going to start with hardness, okay? A material can be soft or hard depending on how easy it is to scratch or cut it, okay? So, soft materials can be cut or scratched very easily. Cotton or sponge are one of those materials, okay? Here you see wool, sponge, cotton, these soft materials that are easy to cut or scratch and everything. And hard materials are difficult to scratch and cut. Examples of hard materials. You've got here wood, you've got diamond, you've got also glass. Glass is a hard material as well, okay? Very good. So this is hardness, the first of the specific properties of matter. Now we are going to see elasticity. Materials, depending on its elasticity, can be elastic, malleable, or rigid. Elastic materials, just like these rubber bands or the balloons, when you apply a force on a material and it gets the form, but it recovers its shape when the force stops, that is elastic material, okay? You apply a force to it, to this rubber band, you apply it to the force, and when you leave it, you stop the force, it recovers the original form, okay? That happened with the balloon, okay? When you put air inside, it grows a lot, and after that, it turns back to the original form. So these are elastic materials. Now, malleable materials. What is this? Malleable. It says, a material that changes when you apply a force on it, but it does not recover its original shape when the force stops. So in the tin can that you see here, when you drink a Coke can and after that you apply force and you deformed it, okay? But after that, the can stays like this, okay? Deformed, because it's a malleable material. It's happened the same with the plasticine, okay? That we have used a lot at school. And finally, rigid materials. So elastic materials, you apply a force and they turn back to the original form. Malleable materials, you apply a force and deform them. And rigid materials are materials that they don't mind if you apply a force. They don't deform. They don't get deformed. We've got two examples here, like a brick or a glass. Here I've got a glass. If I apply force here, it doesn't get deformed, okay? Very easy. Very good. So this is the elasticity, the second of the properties of matter. And now, the transparency. Transparency, depending on the way materials allow light to pass through them, they can be opaque, translucent, or transparent, okay? Wood is opaque. Why? Because light doesn't pass, and you cannot see through them. You know it. You cannot see through wood, you cannot see through paper, because they are opaque, okay? Now, this Tupperware here, blue Tupperware, some plastic are translucent. What does it mean? The light goes through them, but you cannot see clearly through them, okay? So they are translucent, half transparent, half opaque. And now, glass is transparent because the light goes through and you can see perfectly. So our windows are transparent because we can see what's happening on the other side, okay? And not other types of plastic are transparent too. So transparency, opaque, translucent or transparent. Quite easy. Now, density. As you know, the density is the relationship between mass and volume. Okay, mass, what something weighs, and volume, the amount of space that occupies. Okay, very good. In this case, we have two balls, the plastic ball and the metal ball, and the plastic ball may have the same volume, may occupy the same volume as the metal ball, but the metal ball is heavier, has more mass, so is denser than the plastic ball. You understand it? Yes, I think this is quite easy. And now, finally, we're going to see brittleness. And you may say, what is brittleness? It has to do with when something is fragile, okay? Cuando algo es frágil. Very important. A material is brittle when it breaks easily. Hard materials can be brittle too. So, we have seen hard material, just like glass, but if you apply too much force, or if you drop this glass onto the floor, it's going to break. So its material is hard because it's rigid, it's hard, but it's brittle as well. Okay, quite easy. In this example, we've got this wooden ruler, okay, a wooden ruler and a metal bar. So which one is going to break easily? Usually the wooden ruler, so it's more brittle than the metal bar. So the level of brittleness is quite easy to know. And these were the five specific properties that we have studied of matter, okay? So hardness, something materials can be soft or hard. Elasticity, materials can be elastic, malleable, or rigid, okay? Transparency, materials can be opaque, translucent, or transparent. Density, low density or high density. And brittleness, they can be more brittle if they break easily, or less brittle if they are very hard to break. I think it's everything quite simple, and you are going to find it very easy to understand. So if you've got problems, just let me know and I'll help you. So that's it, that was all. Thank you very much for being there, and see you next class. Bye.